Have you ever been fighting with a server application running on your local host and connecting that to a client application, making it work together, debug, HTTPS, and everything? Then this video is for you. I'm going to make your life a whole lot easier with Dev Tunnels. Might have heard of Dev Tunnels before. It was very much integrated in Visual Studio and together with ASP.NET Server applications. You probably wishing that you could use it for other things as well, and now you can. At the past Microsoft Build Conference in May 2023, they announced the Dev Tunnels CLI, so the command line tooling that will allow you to create Dev Tunnels for any solution, whether it's .NET or C# or anything completely else. But you can connect your clients now very easily to your server applications running on your local host. We will see in a little demo what that all entails. This channel is typically about client applications, Blazor, .NET MAUI, so we're going to see a typical .NET MAUI application connecting to a server. But a little bit more about Dev Tunnels first. This is just a little tool that will run on your computer, basically opening up your computer to the big bad internet. So that's there. It can be a little bit more risky, but these sessions should be short-lived. The URLs are not really predictable, and it will make your life a whole lot easier. And you can still secure everything with the headers and other API keys and security that you might have in place. This might all sound very familiar if you've been using ngrok or ngrok before, because that's a tool that does the exact same basically, but now much more integrated and free and from Microsoft. So it's just good to have a little competition and see some innovation going on between them, right? So let's just dive into Visual Studio and see what this is all about. So here I am in Visual Studio 2022, and I set up a very simple example, but this is a very typical setup with a ASP.NET web API on the one side, which is a REST API, and on the other side, I have a .NET MAUI application. Now, again, this doesn't need to be Visual Studio, it doesn't need to be .NET, it doesn't need to be C#, if that's what you want. You can use this Dev Tunnel for everything, basically, that's just running and connecting to each other. It just acts as a proxy, kind of like a tunnel to actually connect the things, right? So there's that. You can also mix and match if you have something running in something else. The ASP.NET server can be PHP, your client can be a command line, or it can be JavaScript. It doesn't really matter. It will still work if you mix and match things. Here we have a very typical setup. I just did file new ASP.NET web API project, and you will get this weather forecast controller out of the box, which just mimics kind of like sending back weather forecasts, random things in JSON format. So you've probably seen this before. It's really not that exciting. So it just outputs some random JSON. That's kind of like the most important thing here. So the other thing that I have, that's this one. This is my server app right here. And then I have this MAUI app client, which is a .NET MAUI app file new .NET MAUI project. And here in the main page, I added one little thing. So I have this label that gets a name so I can reference it from my code behind. And then in the actual code behind, I have something hooked up to the button right here so that it actually gets that JSON from an HTTP client from the weather forecast service, and it will return that into my application. Of course, in an actual application, you would do that, something with that. Now it just outputs the raw JSON, and that's that. Typically, how you would see that happen is you have this base address because that's where the server lives, right? So that's your local host in this case with the port number. And then the endpoints, right? So you don't have to repeat this base address all the time. You just have these endpoints and you can reuse that. With the HTTP client, we are going to connect to that and get the actual string. Now I have the My Server app as the startup project. So if I were to just run this, actually, let me do this like this, Solution Explorer, right click, and then I'm going to do debug, start without debugging. So it will start without debugging so I can switch between the different .NET MAUI clients that I have right here. You will get the Swagger open API stuff. You can actually inspect the output here. So I can do try it now, execute, and you can see that it actually does something. Or I can go to this localhost 7001, and I can do /weather-forecast, and you can see that it outputs the same, right? I get this raw JSON outputted 5 entries, and there we are. So that all works. But now, if you go to set the MAUI app client as the starter project, so let's do that. And if I switch here over to Windows, now it will all be happy, right? I'm going to run my Windows application. People will do that. And then everything will be happy because the Windows app and this server, the ASP.NET server, are running on the same machine, right? So if I click here, everything will work. I get the raw JSON here in this label. Great. So that works. But now then people are like, who, .NET MAUI, it's cross-platform. So I can just switch over to Android. So let me just do that, Android emulator, do that, and deploy it to my Android device. And suddenly things are going to blow up. Because this Android emulator might run on the same machine, but it isn't actually the same machine, right? You should see this Android emulator or the iOS emulator or any maybe the Tizen emulator as a separate device, maybe as a physical device. Because if you do click me now, it's going to go kaboom. It's going to break because it's trying to reach localhost. And what is localhost in this case? Localhost should be this Android emulator thing. So it's going to look for the server on this Android device, and it's not there, right? It's on our Windows machine. So now we have problems. You can see fail to connect localhost, so this is not working. Now, what you would typically do from here on out is go find your outside IP address on your local machine, and you will have to go here into your My Server app properties, launch settings.json. You will have to replace this localhost with something like this so that it accepts connections from the outside as well. And suddenly, if you do that, you're going to connect to something like I don't know, HTTPS 192.168.0.1/weather-forecast, right? So this is a typical local address that you could find. And if you do that, HTTPS is not going to work because the HTTPS certificate is created for the local host name. So now you can't connect to it. And even if you can, if you're working with Android and iOS, then suddenly they're going to complain because, you know, the HTTPS certificate is not valid. So then you can say, okay, I want to go to the HTTP endpoint, but then they say, hey, this is not secure. So now you have to do extra code, extra entries in the manifest to allow for unsecure connections. Maybe somehow someone makes a mistake that ends up in production code. That's all not great and not very secure, all stuff that you do not want. That's where the dev tunnels come in, right? So I'll get back to this HTTP and HTTPS stuff in a little bit as well. Let me just undo all of this. Because typically you want to run the HTTPS endpoint for your ASP.NET server as well, right? But for this dev tunnels, that's probably not what you want to do. So let's look at dev tunnels. Let's go to the documentation page actually. So I have that open right here. You can find the link down below in the video description. The documentation right now is very, let's say, concise. At the time of recording, this has just been released, but all the details are here to get you started. So you can see it actually supports Windows, macOS, and Linux, so that's very cool. And we have these commands here that will get you started. So you can just invoke web request and it will download it to a location on your computer, or you can download it here as some kind of installer or whatnot, and you will get it on your machine that way. So let's open this command line here, and we need to do this in PowerShell, so let's do this. I'm going to type CLS first to clear the screen and not distract you with all kinds of other things. And I'm going to paste in the command here, and it's going to say, hey, oh, warning, something's going on here. Do you actually want to do this? Yes, I want to, so paste anyway. And now it's going to invoke this web request to this URL output file to devtunnel.exe, and we get this second command here in as well, because we can now just execute devtunnel.exe-h, and we will get all the help in here, right? So we have all the help and all the options. Now, I'm not going to go over all the options right here, but there is a lot of stuff to cover, and that will probably only become more in upcoming versions. The important thing is that you need to log in first to actually use this, either with a Azure AD account, a Microsoft account, or a GitHub account. And if you just do .slash, because it's PowerShell, so you need to do .slash, you can of course do it from any command line window, dev tunnels, and I can say user login. It will actually pop a screen. It will go to this by default. I can select my Microsoft account here, and it will actually say, hey, login complete, because I'm already logged in here. You might need to enter your password, do two-factor authentication, but this is maybe your typical scenario if you're logged into your browser already. And we can go here back to our command line, and you can see, hey, I'm logged in via Microsoft with this email address, and now I'm ready to go. So the most basic usage is then .slash dev tunnel host, and you can also do again --- help, so you will get all the help for this. And you can see that you again have a bunch of things. You can also use and reuse existing tunnel IDs so that the URL is a little bit more predictable. Go figure that out for yourself. I'm just going to go with the basic scenario for now. You can specify a port number, very important, and the allow anonymous, which is also very important. So Let's just start with the first one, the port one. So I'm going to say dash slash dev tunnel host, and then dash p for port. And then I'm going to say 8080, just do something, right? And now it's going to start a tunnel with a random URL. You're getting a bunch of info here, and it's running on 8080, right? So it's going to get that port 8080 on the outside, and it's going to pipe that through to whatever is running on 8080 on your local machine. Now, in this case, nothing is running here, so let's just stop this for a second. You can press Control C to actually stop running here, and it will kill the tunnel, and it won't be able to connect from the outside anymore. So there's that. Now, let's go back to our server here. So I actually have this server process here, and you can see, hey, it's running on HTTP 5015 and HTTPS 7041. So we have all of that. But what you really want to do is run it on HTTP and make sure that it connects to HTTP. Because if you would now go to this HTTP endpoint, it's going to automatically upgrade to HTTPS. And that's not something we want, because I haven't been able to figure it out. I'm not the best wizard with all this HTTPS kind of stuff. So maybe you can do it better. But if you do HTTPS on the dev tunnels and also connect that to HTTPS on your ASP.NET server integration, then it's going to not connect properly. I don't know how better to explain it. So what I've been doing, and I don't think that is necessarily less secure, is use the HTTPS of the dev tunnels and just use that to connect to the HTTP of your ASP.NET server, right? So to do that, you can do that in a couple of ways. Let's go back to Visual Studio, and you can see I ran this profile, right? So you have different profiles, HTTP, HTTPS, and I've been running this HTTPS one, and you have these two endpoints. But now in your program.cs, you have this use HTTPS redirection, so it will automatically upgrade whenever that is available. So either do something smart here so that it doesn't do this redirection whenever you are using the dev tunnels. You can probably come up with some code like is not development or that kind of stuff, or you want to just launch the right profile right here. So let me go to this server app, set that as the startup client, and here in the run menu you can just select HTTP, so it's just going to run only the HTTP endpoint, so only this local host 5015, and you can just use that. So if I do that, and I go back here, you can see the server process is running, now listening on localhost 5015, and I do this dev tunnel again, but now on 5015, we will get some more information. Again, random tunnel here, and I can connect this endpoint right here. So let me copy this one, go to my browser, and you can see that it does nothing, probably. Well, it will ask me first to log in. By default, you will have to log in because it's only authorized for you, so that no one on the outside can just connect to it. So we can do that, and then we're piped through. We will get this little warning. You will get this anyway, always the first time. It gives a little information like, hey, this is not something that's in production. So maybe it's even phishing, right? People could misuse this if you want to, do not disclose personal information, etc., etc., and just continue. Now we get a 404 because there's nothing here. I need to go to the weather forecast and endpoint, and now actually get this stuff here on my local machine through this outside URL. And you can actually see here that it gets some of the requests right here. So it shows you some output here. You have the verbose flag to show even more. So we have all of this. And which is also cool is that you can inspect. So we get this inspect URL, and we can copy that. And if we go to that, it will open your browser tools. So go to the inspect one. I again need to log into my account. And whenever I do that, it comes up with these things. And then if I reload here and get new things, you will see all the requests coming by here, and I can inspect what is going over the line. So that's pretty cool too. You can see all the things that are going over the network here in much detail, so you can debug that way if that is where your problem is. So, okay, there's that. But you can see each request that I do to this prompts me with a little login window, which is kind of annoying if you want to do this from a .NET MAUI application, right? So that's not something that we can do. So let's just kill this tunnel again, Control C. And now I'm adding the dash A for anonymous. So now it allows anonymous access, so anyone can access this. If you were watching this right now, the tunnel is already gone. But if you were watching this live, you could go to this URL and you could see the same thing. So let me just copy this again, paste it in here, do weather forecast. And you will still get this window. So you might still have to do the continue here, maybe for the first request in your .NET MAUI application. You want to go with a browser to this and then continue, and then all the subsequent requests will be all right from here. But you can see that I actually get it now, and whenever I do refresh or whenever I go to this inspect URL, I can now just go there anonymously. So that also means that it's now up to you to kind of like, this kind of like disproves my point, but I think that that might be because of the inspect one, but this will also means that you have to take care of like the security here, right, with like your headers and API keys that you might have in place, which is probably all right because this is short-lived and just for debugging purposes mostly, but it is something that you want to be aware of. Okay, so we have this now. Let's just apply this to our .NET MAUI app. Actually, let me get the URL here again. Hosting on port this and this, because what we can do now is go back to our main page, and instead of this local host with this port, I can now say, hey, I want to use this URL. Let's make sure that our slashes line up so that we don't run into anything weird. So now we have this outside URL. I don't have to disable HTTPS stuff in my Android app, my iOS app. I don't have to figure out like, hey, localhost, blah, blah. It can't connect because it's looking for the server on my Android device. We now have all of this. So if I now do run debug, start new instance on my Android client again, then I should come up with the Android application. It's now using this endpoint, and I should see the same raw JSON output as I would see in my application as well, in the browser, in like any other thing, because it's using this outside URL, right? So I'm going to click this, and you can see this raw JSON coming up here in my Android application as well. Much easier than setting all these things manually, trying to connect, trying to figure out, just run this little command line tool, spin that up, and you are ready to go to debug your client and server application. Very easy, no? So what do you think? Are you going to use this? Have you already been using it? Do you maybe prefer ngrok, ngrok? Why so? I'd be very curious to know. Let me know down in the comments if that is the case. If you still want to make up your mind on what's what, I also have a video from ngrok right here on my channel, so be sure to check that out. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel, and I'll be seeing you on the other side of the tunnel. See you for the next one.